My name's Chad Fust. I work in computing and information services here at Vassar College. I got into home brewing about 4 years ago, 4 to 5 years ago. The legend, of course, of Matthew Vassar is that, you know, he brewed this amazing beer, and that basically gave him the funds, the fortune that he used to found Vassar College. So I had heard, of course, of other people doing research, trying to find the recipe. It was always Matthew Vassar's ale recipe, Matthew Vassar's beer recipe. Where's the recipe? Does the recipe exist? I would go into in special collections on my lunch breaks and go through the papers and try to decode some of the really scrawled, difficult to read handwriting.
These are basically receipts, if not order forms.
And this is interesting because this says for Southern trade and city use. They made special beers for shipping south, for shipping to warmer climates that were stronger, more heavily hopped.
It has a cool engraving of the brewery right down on the Hudson.
One day I happened upon a roll of microfilm that was simply labeled brewing accounts. As I looked more closely and again decoded that handwriting, I realized that they were actually brewing logs. So the first thing you see, of course, is just the title, Brewing Accounts of 1833 to 1837. But within the logs, there are columns of numbers. The first column is the batch number, essentially, then the date. Then they start with bushels of hops, bushels of malt, how long they boiled the wort for, how long they fermented for, how many barrels of yeast they added. On the facing page, there are remarks or notes for each brewing session, and they mention usually how much salt they added. Sometimes they would mention that they used some malt from a previous batch to create a beer. And sometimes they even mention where those hops or where the malt was from, where in New York or the Northeast those ingredients came from. That process was a lot more organic. They sort of brewed based on what they had in stock. They brewed what they needed to have on hand. And it was a very different philosophy on brewing. Today it's completely different. Today it's all about efficiency, it's all about consistency. And you're not considered a good brewer today if you can't consistently make the same beer every single time. This is a really exciting discovery because, you know, the emphasis for such a long time was on the recipe and what kind of beer did Matthew Vassar brew. And what we actually find in the logs is a record of a lot of different beers brewed over a pretty significant period of time. And that's better than a recipe, because if we had found a recipe, we don't know if he had actually followed that recipe. But the logs are a record of this is what the brewers did on this day. And so we can say with a pretty high degree of confidence, this beer that we brewed is a very close approximation of what Vassar brewed, you know, in the 1830s. And we can actually take those local ingredients and make that beer in the spirit of Matthew Vassar, and to me that's really exciting, because as we all know, there wouldn't be a Vassar College without Matthew Vassar's ale.